What is for you the essence of project management? What are the essential project activities that you execute?
Yeah, for me the essence of project management is that you start with a general idea on what you want to do in the orientation phase, that you agree on the requirements and the scope you want to deliver in this project. And then during what we call the creation phase, where you do the engineering, that you work from a high over inaccuracy, plus or minus 60% on budget, for example, to plus or minus 10%. And within this phasing, there are like two gates where every time you reconsider, are we still complying with the deliverables, with the requirements and with the scope that we have agreed before, and is the budget and planning that we are finding right now still in line with what we are want from this project as a company. If I look at it per phase, then in the orientation phase, for me, the most key is that we agree on requirements and scope, because I've noticed that during projects, that's also always where you get most discussion about. Once you have agreed that and you can move into the engineering phase, you need to work out your planning and your budget. That's for me the two ones that require most attention. And with budget, I noticed that you need a certain level of detail, but you should not wait too long before you really have a kind of high over figure, because then you can already start the discussion, is this really the project we want? And working it out more in detail, that's just requiring time with having contacts with suppliers and experts in the field. But this high over idea, where are we going to? That's for me key, that you can already start this discussion as a project manager with the organization. And on planning, there I noticed that it's very important to have this discussion also beforehand, because as an organization, it always takes more time than you think to get things done. So you can plan really your activities, but on top of that, there's also the approval process, getting the right signatures, getting approval of your budget. And that time you also have to incorporate in your project right from the beginning, because it will also determine how at what moment you can be active in the market, when a new product will be launched. And this discussion you should not have at the end of your engineering, but right from the beginning. So for my role as project manager, there for me is the most crucial part. And during the engineering, that will be worked more out by my team. But I can already have all the discussions on outside the project, on really outside the content, on all these other deliverables. And then in the execution phase, so where we're really doing the project, there then you have approved CAPEX, you have agreed what you're going to do. And then for me, key is scope management. So the scope management procedure, scope change procedure, which changes are requested by the organization, by your supplier, by your whole surrounding, and how is it going to affect your project? There you have really a high risk of getting out of control if you do not manage that well.
When do you decide to deviate from the standards? Under which circumstances would you perform additional activities, for instance, or less activities?
We have this a different size of projects. Within our organization, all projects larger than 1.5 million are part of the project organization. And those projects can go up maybe to 100 million. Depending on the size of your project, it's also, of course, important that you look what are you doing and what not. If you have a very defined project where you know exactly what you're going to do, it's no use to have three different engineering phases to go from conceptual to pre to basic engineering. You know what you do, the requirements are clear, you have agreed on the scope, and it's just finding a technical solution to do it. Then you can just squeeze these engineering phases into a more compact one and not do the complete phasing there. On the other hand, if you have a project where you're, for example, going to develop a new product that has to be scaled up with a new factory, then you need to take a lot of time in the conceptual engineering, because in the end, that's where you are going to determine how the product will look like, what are the requirements, and that will affect your engineering process. What are the requirements from the product to be able to produce it? So in this case, I would put more emphasis on the conceptual engineering, while in other projects where this uncertainty is not there, I would not use this. And the same is for all the assurance part, where you're going to look more into your product, how well the design was, how well you have captured the costs. there, I think it really depends on the uncertainty you have in your project. In some cases, it's a very clear scope with one supplier that's going to do the project. That's different than when you have 10 or 20 different suppliers that all have to work together. There's much more uncertainty on who's going to do what. So in that case, there's much more to gain in value engineering, in process design optimizations. So in that case, I would put more emphasis on these parts than I would do in a project where this is much more easy.
This is all focused on the technical activities. Is there any influence from the surroundings, the location where you execute the project, or the neighborhood where you do it in? Will that have an effect on your activities?
Partly. Yeah, we define difference between brownfield and greenfield scope, for example. In greenfield scope, you can determine your own scope, your own surroundings. In brownfield scope, you're doing your project in a working factory with a history where equipment is there, where cables, everything is already in place. So that also requires much more detailed engineering to really look at what you will meet when you're going to do the execution in such an area. So in that case, I think the basic engineering is a much more important step to really go into detail, also on PNID level, to do HACCPs or all these kind of steps. Because in the end, that will determine in the execution how well the project will go.
How do you benefit from value engineering in your projects?
Yeah, value engineering is an important step in a project to look at the maximum value you can gain with your project. So you look both at cost but also at benefit. What I see is it's a very powerful tool, but it should not be done too late into the engineering phase. If you do value engineering when the team has almost moved from the pre to basic engineering or is even already in the basic engineering phase, the degrees of freedom to change the design, to really get different ideas in, is very difficult to address anymore. Then you really would have to move back to the kind of pre-engineering. So in that respect, what I really like is the idea of conceptual value engineering. Is where you have different concepts worked out with the team, already in a certain level of detail, but there's still the possibility to change to a different scenario. And if you have the discussion with a team, also with people outside your location or from other parts of the company, that look from a different angle at your product and can ask open questions, but also bring a lot of knowledge that you normally have not so easily access to, then you can have this discussion in an early stage of your engineering phase. And still choose for another scenario than you would maybe have chosen. And for the real value engineering, which is typically between pre and basic engineering, then you do not have these questions anymore, the challenge on the scenarios that were worked out during the project or have been chosen not to continue with. But there you can really focus on the last value you can get out of this value engineering by some improvements you can still do. Or some optimizations, but you do not have to change your complete process anymore.